people always ask, is PSI or GPM important? They both are. Let's talk about the analogy between PSI and gallons per minute. When you've got your garden hose running, you've got maybe 6 or 7 GPM coming out of that hose. That's 7 gallons per minute or 6 gallons a minute. You might have 20 or 30 or 40 PSI coming out of that garden hose. Throw your thumb on top of that and start restricting the flow. You're gonna see a higher pressure. It's gonna come out stronger. That's basically what a pressure washer does. It's restricting the flow through one of these little nozzles over here. You got your 0 degree, your 15 degree, your 25 degree, 65 degree. You can see the nozzles and the openings are going to be a little bit wider. They're going to be shaped a little bit differently to give you a little different spray pattern on there. So that's kind of what they look like up close. So you've got 20 or 30 or 40 PSI coming through a nozzle this small on a pressure washer. Depending on the pump that's used with that and the power behind that pump that's coupled to the engine, that's going to give you that higher pressure. Whether it's going to be 2,000 PSI, 3,000 PSI, 4,000 PSI, that all comes into play with the pump and the engine that's coupled together and the size of the orifice on that nozzle. So that's what's going to give you your extra pressure on there, and that's what's going to add and dictate the cost of that unit as well. So say you got really heavy stains in your garage floor, in your deck, or in your sidewalks. PSI is going to be a lot more important for that. You want pressure to do the job for you. Bird droppings around the house, gum on the sidewalk, stuff like that. You probably want a little bit heavier flow rate to be able to handle that along with the PSI. The amount of flow or the gallon per minute is the volume of water behind that pressure is also going to aid in cleaning your surface much faster as well. A lot of people now get into soft washing, which means you're using a lower PSI but a higher flow rate, a higher GPM. So you're not damaging anything, but it's going to be a good 1500 to 2000 PSI with a good amount of volume of water behind that, or GPM, to provide that washing. Those are some important things you want to look at. We also list cleaning units on the website. That's basically multiplying the PSI times the GPM to give you a number that gives you an idea of how fast you might clean a job. So the higher the number you're looking at, the faster you're going to do a job in cleaning whatever you're working on. 4,000, 5,000 PSI, you're going to start stripping paint, you're going to start actually stripping layers of cement with that kind of pressure. It can actually be a very deadly weapon too, so you want to be very careful when you're using this kind of equipment as well, because you can take off a limb or something like that with that kind of pressure, so it's nothing to play around with as well. When we talk about consumer versus prosumer and professional, again, we're talking about differences there between what kind of engine, whether it's just a standard consumer grade engine or a commercial engine on that machine, and what type of pump is on the machine. That's going to have a direct bearing on professional and semi-pro and consumer. So again, gallon per minute and pressure is important in both aspects. It really comes down to what you're actually looking to do. All right, so for sizing nozzles for pressure washers, it's important to know what the PSI and GPM rating of your pressure washer is. All of these nozzles, whether it's a standard nozzle like this or turbo nozzles, are coming in different orifice sizes. Those orifice sizes relate to the pressure and GPM rating of your machine. If you get the wrong orifice, you're not going to get the full potential or performance of that nozzle with your machine you're using. You might get a little higher pressure out of it, which isn't going to really be good for the machine. You might get lower pressure, which isn't going to be good for the performance. So it's important to get the right orifice size for those different tips that you're looking to replace or buy. The other thing I want to point out too on these tips, they do wear out after time. So, you know, if you've been using the same tips over and over for a year and a half or 2 years and you see that you're getting low pressure on your machine, it's probably time to buy in new tips for your machine. They're going to wear out, you're going to see a decrease in pressure, and that could be one reason why you're seeing that. After all this great information we provided for you today, you're still on the fence, you're still not sure what you want to look for, go to pressurewashersdirect.com/best and you'll find all the recommended pressure washers, all the best accessories, everything else you need to know is going to be right there for you to check out. If you're still not sure, feel free to give us a call. We're here to help you.